Welcome to this week's episode of The Dragon's Lair. I'm Patrick Heffron. Thanks for joining us. Our first story is about the rise of eSports in America and how the Warren County School District is attempting to enter the field.
The eSports industry has blown up in the last 10 years. Beginning with something small and obscure, it has exploded to just under $1 billion in 2019 and is expected to grow to over $1.6 billion in 2023.
One of the biggest corporations in the esports industry, Twitch, supports streamers all around the world, some of which can even make a living off the industry. For example, Tyler Blevins, better known by his online name Ninja, is estimated to be worth over $25 million USD. His career of choice, streaming.
Warren County School District started their own esports league last year. It is run by Mr. Joe English, a teacher here at Warren Area High School. We offer games such as Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, Fortnite, and Overwatch.
I joined esports because I was a huge fan of playing video games. My favorite thing about esports is that so many of my friends are in it, so I get to both interact with them and also play video games. I think that everyone there, including the teacher, Mr. English, is very knowledgeable on what they're doing. So if you ask anybody for help, they'll be able to help you.
Why do you think esports should be involved with high schools across the country?
It gives another avenue for students to explore. Usually you have the sports programs, you have your football, your basketball, all that. Right. And those students always gravitate towards those activities, where then you usually have your other students that they don't feel like they belong. Mm-hmm. And this is just one other avenue for to get more kids involved with the school and such things like that.
If someone wants to sign up for esports, how do they do it? Where do they find you?
Well, I'm in room B114. So if they're interested in any of those games, just come see me, give me a name, we'll put you in the system.
Reporting from the Dragon's Lair, this has been Camden Dreher.
And this has been Patrick Heffron. Good job, Camden. Wait, aren't you on the esports team?
Yeah, I'm hoping to compete on the Smash Bros. Team.
That's awesome. I'm more of a Rocket League guy myself.
You should join. We could always use some more players. Our next package comes from Haley Martin, who brings to you this film review with a couple of her friends.
With the struggles related to theater closures and production delays, it is estimated that the entertainment industry could potentially lose $160 billion in the next 5 years. With that in mind, we in the Dragon's Lair wanted to help stimulate the economy, so we decided to purchase a film and review it for you. As it is the season for scares, we turn to the horror genre. We chose the film, The Cleaning Lady. The movie follows the story of a cleaning lady named Shelley being hired by a woman named Alice. The relationship between Shelley and Alice grows as the movie goes on. Over time, Shelley becomes obsessed with Alice.
So, after watching the movie, how do you feel about it?
The movie was excruciating. I did not like the movie. It was not scary at all. And I expected to be scary, and it just wasn't. And so it's not for me.
Well, like, there was that one pretty gory part, too, that I found kind of disgusting, which I don't...
The poison? The acid?
Hydrochloric?
It was gruesome and gory. However, it was not scary. I wanted to keep watching at that part. I'm like, ooh,
me
blood.
Too. It didn't give the jump scare factor to it.
No, it just made me, like, want to turn the movie off.
That interesting?
Yeah. No, because, like, I didn't want to watch her stab him. I thought that the movie was, like, I didn't really find it that great.
Other than that, I think the actors did their job pretty very well. The plot, for me, was very complicated. Too many things to the plot. Kind of a little bit complicated, but I understood it after watching it all. Definitely did not give the jump scare factor of a horror movie should have. But other than that, I think it was pretty good. So how many stars would you give it then?
Maybe 2.5 out of 5.
I'd give it 2 stars.
I'll give it the benefit of the doubt. 3 out of 5, definitely. So would you recommend this to somebody, or?
I would not.
I definitely would not.
No. Hello, I'm Nick Norod. I'm going to be giving you guys your weather, both a look back at this week and a look ahead at next week. If you guys in the booth could give me my weather map now, please. Oh. All right, I can try my best with this. So, all right, it looks like that's the wrong direction. So over here, looks like we have nice sunny blue skies, of course, over here towards the west coast. Yeah, all right. And then, of course, in the middle here, just a lot of, wow, what even is this? I'm going to call that red hot. Red hot. Just a lot of red in there. Okay, well, Great Lakes, of course, always blue, and in the Great Lakes, always, of course. Duh, they're blue. That's water. That's the color of water. And then, yeah, got some nice, Guys, you gave me the wrong, I'm supposed to be doing the weather. What are you, all right, well, that's all we have for you this week. We're going to leave you with a look at this year's football season with a package from Aiden Flannery. We'll see you next time.
I believe my speed is my best ability that helps make me the most effective on offense. Speed and agility, that's about it.
I'd say my speed definitely is a huge impact, and just knowledge of the game.
La 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 la.